plus one equals two. That happens every day. That is not magic. That's the grind. It's when you get up one, go to work one, go to bed two. Two geniuses, two. But when one plus one equals three, that's when your life changes. And you see everything new. And these are days when you are visited by visions, when the world around you brings down the spirit and you feel blessed to be alive. It is the essential equation of love. There is no love without one plus one equaling three. It's the essential equation of art. It's the essential equation of rock and roll. It's the reason the universe will never be fully comprehensible. It's the reason Louie Louie will never be fully comprehensible. And it's the reason true rock and roll and true rock and roll bands will never die. Dead drops on the city bed, Scooter searching for his groove. Oh, we're walking pretty and you can't find the room to move over, that's all. I'm running on the bad side with my back to the wall. 10th Avenue freeze out. 10th Avenue freeze out. I'm stranded in the jungle trying to take in all the heat that they're giving. Hey, the night is dark, the sidewalk's bright in line with the light of living. From a tenement window, a transistor blast. Turn around the corner, things got real quiet real fast. I walked into a 10th Avenue freeze out. 10th Avenue freeze out. And I'm all alone. I'm all alone. I can't find my way back home now. Now Gary, Danny, Little Steven, Mighty Max, Professor Roy, Nils Lofgren, Patty Scalfa, that is my one plus one equals
three.
Excellent, Grasshopper. But nobody captured my audience's imagination or their hearts like Clarence. Clarence was a figure out of a rock and roll storybook, and together we told a story that was bigger than any of the ones I'd written in my songs. It was a story where not only did Scooter and the Big Man bust the city in half, but we remade the city. We remade the city, shaping into the kind of place where our friendship and our love for one another wouldn't have been such an exceptional thing. First night I saw Clarence, he came walking out of the shadows towards the bandstand, nodded to me, got up, stood to my right for the very first time. He picked up his saxophone, and when he played, he whispered that story in my ear. And then we whispered it in your ear. And we carried it together for a long good time. The Big Man was big. Everything about him, his personality, his size, his laugh, the sound of his saxophone. When I first heard it, I thought it was the biggest sound I ever heard. And it was. His heart, his problems, they were big. But he was elemental in my life. and losing them was like losing the rain. If I were a mystic, I guess Clarence and my friendship would lead me to believe that we stood together in other older times, you know, in other lives, along other rivers, in other ancient cities, in other fields, working side by side with the sun setting, doing our modest version of God's work. I'll see you in the next life, big man. When they made that change uptown and the big man joined the band, from the coastline to the city hall, the little pretties raised their hands. I'm gonna sit back right easy and laugh when Scooter and the big man bust the city in half with the 10th Avenue freeze out. 10th Avenue freeze out. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the biggest man you ever saw.